Your Steve Jones Show podcast is loading now. The Steve Jones Show podcast is sponsored by Sunbury Motors, North 4th Street in Sunbury, and Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. Sports talk where your voice counts. This is the Steve Jones Show on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Now, from the Sunbury Motors Studio, here's Steve Jones.
Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. And you can go online to sunburymotors.com. Ford, Lincoln, Kia, Hyundai. Incredible pre-owned inventory. Sales staff that has plenty of deals to talk to you about. A service department that takes care of the life of the vehicle. All at Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors, Kia, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf, and online at sunburymotors.com. Great to have you with us on the show today. Jesse Luketa in a few moments, but first, into the archives we go for the great Harry Callis on our play-by-play call of the day.
Myers has the sign from Frisco's. Curveball struck him out. The Phillies are National League East champions. Look at the scene on the field. Look at the scene on the stands. This is incredible. The Phillies are National League East champions and look forward to the postseason for the first time since 1993.
A great moment for the Phillies. The next year they ended up winning the World Series. And a great moment for us to air the great Harry Callis. And by the way, the worthy successor to the great Harry Callis we had with us yesterday, Scott Fransky, who has been able to really entrench himself as a trusted voice that people admire so much of the Phillies. And Eagle 107 will have the Phillies this year. All right. I've mentioned this before. Every time I talk with Jack Ham, he says, Steve, I just can't get past our linebackers. He says, you know, I look at Parsons, I look at Smith. He says, Ellis Brooks, Jesse Luketa. He says, no, and then you go back that, Lance Dixon, Charlie Catcher, you know, the Jacobs kid that's coming in. I can't really talk about him, not because I'm not allowed to, it's because I've never seen him. But I've heard great things about him. Jesse Luketa yesterday had an opportunity to talk with the media, starting with Jerry DiPaolo from the Pittsburgh Tribune.
Hello, Jesse. How are you?
I'm doing well. Yourself?
Good, good. I was just curious. You come from a rather large family with a lot of siblings. How do they like having you home in the springtime for the first time in a long time?
It was a good time. I got to spend a lot of quality time with all my nieces and nephews, so I enjoyed it. I haven't spent that much time with family since I left home, so...
How long have you been to State College?
So I recently just returned to State College. I got back here last Thursday night.
Mark Brennan, Fight On State.
Hey, Jesse, thank you for doing this today.
Pleasure. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. I wonder, can you tell us what you did while you were up in Canada? I guess there were some videos of you working out in the snow and whatnot. And what was the process like getting back to the States? Was it tricky at all?
So when I was home, the biggest thing for me was just training. I couldn't get complacent. So originally when I first returned, I was in Ottawa, my hometown. I spent some time there. I was training with a couple of guys, a couple of other teammates, Jonathan Sutherland, and a couple other guys who they attend other institutions across the country. But then I went to go visit my family in Edmonton, Alberta, on the west coast of Canada. So while my time out there, I wasn't really able to access any facilities. So it was honestly just, you know, jail workouts, push-ups, dips in the house. You know, Coach D, she was able to send me some weight vests, some bands, a kettlebell. So I started to get more a little intricate with my workouts in there. But as time started to progress, I finally came back to Ottawa and I was able to work out with my trainer and Claude Giroux, Ben Hutton, a couple of NHL guys. So we got some good work just to make sure I was keeping, you know, physically prepared. And I was, as far as like mentally, I was making sure to stay sharp with my film and everything. But as pertaining to your question about getting back to the United States, it was kind of hard at first because travel is still banned and everything. So as far as myself and Jonathan, we had our paperwork to get back in the country, but the question was if we'd be able to cross if somebody drove us. So I had to have one of my coaches drive us to the border. He dropped us off there, and then we had a representative from Penn State come and pick us up, and they brought us back to State College.
Rich Carosella, Reading Eagle.
Hi, Jesse. Thanks for your time. Can you tell us, when did you first start working out with Giroux? I know it was a few years ago. How did that happen? And how did you guys reconnect, I guess, while you were home this year?
So I think me and Chloe started working out since, I want to say, like 2016, 2017. But I've known him since I was a kid, because my coach, who really has a big part in, you know, where I am now, you know, if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be here. With the countless trips, taking care of me, helped me at one point. His name was Daniel Estrella. So he owned a Greco Lean and Fit Fitness. It was a chain group owned by Tony Greco. So like Greco Lean and Fit, they train NHL players. So I remember I was young. I would walk into the facility. I see guys like Mike Fisher, Carrie Underwood, which at the time I didn't know who she was. And I have a funny story. So she was in the facility. And like I'd walk in and say hi, Carrie, but I never like knew who Carrie Underwood was. And Mike Fisher was there, whatever. I was just a little kid. I'd come in the facility, head out, go play football. And then later on, when they left, I ended up seeing her on the commercial for the NFL intro. And I was like, wait, that's Carrie. And then my coach was like, yeah, that's her. So it was hilarious. But so that's how I met them initially when I was younger. But as it started to grow and they started thinking I was taking football more seriously, they started allowing me to work out with them. And Tony Greco, you know, he's been a big part of, you know, my progression as well. He trains me whenever I'm able to get home. You know, I always have a place in this facility. And me and Claude, you know, he's a dude that he does not get tired. So training out with him, I always got to be my P's and Q's. So I love working with him. He's someone I always keep in my corner. We stay in contact.
Greg Pickle, Penn Live.
Hi, Jesse. Good afternoon. How are you?
Good. And yourself?
I'm doing well, thank you. What has it been like to be back in State College around your teammate now, and how have the workouts been going?
So since I've been back, I've honestly been in my hotel room training by myself. I go to the field, get some work in. But as far as like training with my teammates, I haven't really been around them or the facilities just yet. So they just want me to stay around here and just wait it out for a little bit.
Next question is Audrey Snyder with The Athletic.
Hey, Jesse, thanks for your time this afternoon. I'm wondering, going back to, you said, with the border and getting here, I mean, were you concerned at one point once you went home that, you know, maybe getting back was going to be a bit of a nightmare?
Yes and no, because initially, like, I had returned home for spring break. So, you know, it was funny because we had asked our athletic team, our people, if, you know, there'd be any issues with the COVID thing and whatnot, but they told us no, there's no problem. So I went home, and once I got home and they let us know that we were going to be closed, I was kind of concerned, as I didn't know how long I'd be in Canada for, or if I'd be able to get back into the U.S. And get back to the team. So there were some concerns at the time, but I'm just grateful to be back here.
Next up is Nubias Wilborn with the Pittsburgh Post-Gazette.
Hey, man, how's it going, brother? Man, I'm doing fine, dude. Just trying to get through this thing. You know how I go. From there, man, what has it been like just the past 2 weeks? What's been the toughest part about the transition back to State College over the last 2 weeks?
I say the toughest part about my transition is just I've been kind of lonely. Like, I'm in my hotel room. Everything I do is kind of by myself. There's a couple other dudes who are in the hotel with me as well, so I'm with them. But, yeah, like, it's weird being back in State College, and I want to be around all my guys, all my brothers, but, you know, I got to keep my distance. That's what's most important, because, you know, you really want to make sure we're doing what's in the best interest for the team to ensure we have the best opportunity of having a season this year. So.
Peter Terpstra, WTAJ.
Hey, Jesse. I'm curious, is the coronavirus situation any different in Canada? And I don't know, have you noticed any kind of difference in how folks are how, whether it's local governments or whatever, how folks are handling the pandemic compared Canada and here?
I wouldn't say there's much of a difference. You know, in Canada, it's the same thing. You know, a lot of places were shut down. You know, they imposed the quarantine, the social distances, and everything. So, you know, while I was back home in Canada, honestly, like, I was in the house. I was working out in the house. If I went to run, it'd be like in the woods, run some hills, come back home. That's really it. I wasn't really out and about, I would say. It's the same thing as far as you know, government policies and everything. I feel as if they've implemented the same restrictions here in the United States as they have in Canada. So,
our next question is John Petishnok, happybelly.com. John, great to see your face.
Yeah, good to see you, Greg, and good to see you, Jesse. Appreciate your time today and hope you're doing well. Hey, speaking of your family, last season I got some video footage of you with your family during team arrival at Beaver Stadium. And after the game, you said that you always want to play your best football when you have your loved ones in the stands. So I just wanted to follow up on that and ask, how big of a support system has your family been for you? And are there ways that they motivate you or inspire you during your career?
Absolutely. You know, growing up, my mom always told me, like, it takes a village. You know, I'm the youngest of seven, so, you know, I have a whole village behind me. So it's like she did all of that on her own. She played both roles. So, you know, seeing the sacrifices she made, you know, the fact that she let a young 14-year-old leave her home, you know, to pursue her dreams by himself, you know, I know it didn't sit well with her. So, you know, she's my motivation. You know, everything I do is for her. She's my rock. But as far as playing a role as a motivation for me, yeah, absolutely. I say I wouldn't be doing what I do now if it wasn't for them. You know, I've been able to study abroad. I've been able to receive a free education. You know, with that, I'm in a position where I'll be able to graduate early and pursue, you know, my aspirations of potentially receiving a master's degree. You know, and that's something that, you know, where I come from, let alone a second generation immigrant, you know, hailing from the Democratic Republic of Congo, that doesn't happen too much. So, you know, I'm forever grateful for everything my mom, my siblings have done for me, even my cousins, because I feel like every little victory that I have, you know, they have a little piece, they have a little part in that. So, you know, it's bigger than.
Tyler Donahue, Lions 247.
Hey, Jesse, great to hear from you and glad to hear everything's going well.
How you doing?
I'm doing good. I just wanted to talk about, a couple of years ago, you mentioned wanting to really set the standard high for Canadian prospects and keep them coming to Penn State. You got Malik and Theo in this class. Penn State's doing more in recruiting up there beyond the 2020 class. How much pride do you take in that? And your name comes up a lot when these guys visit campus as someone who stands out and helps bring them to campus ultimately. What is your role in making sure that Penn State's developing a pipeline in Canada?
I mean, you know, there's so much talent in Canada. You know, I feel like, you know, at times it's underappreciated because, you know, the Canadian stereotype of, oh, you know, he's from Canada. Maybe he's not strong enough. He's not good enough. So, you know, having these kids, especially guys from my own city, guys like Christian, you know what I mean, guys like Malik, who he's from Montreal, but it's right down the road from Ottawa. So even when I was back home in Ottawa, I got work with him. There was actually a carpool of like seven cars full of kids that came from Montreal. We had a big training session, you know, just stuff like that, being able to get back to the community. You know, there's an opportunity for them to leave, you know, our current situations for bigger and better things. So, you know, when I have the opportunity to host those guys when they come on the campus, I mean, it's not really hard for me. I don't sell them a pitch. I'm not a car salesman. I keep it real simple with them. I keep it 100 with them. I let them know that, yeah, Penn State, yeah, one of the best institutions in the country, if not the world. You know, you got an opportunity to play football, get a world-class degree and network and connect with a lot of individuals who have been here before you, continue to network with people who are going to be here after you. So, you know what I mean? They love it. I love being able to be, I say, quote unquote, a Canadian ambassador for Penn State. So,
that is Jesse Luketa. It's interesting. The reporters were loud and clear, and his was a little more distant. That's part of these Zoom calls, so we apologize for that. We will hear from Sandy Barber tomorrow. Sandy Barber did say that spring college football would be a last resort to safely squeeze in the sport. said discussions about potentially playing college football in the spring began as soon as college athletics came to a halt in March. And remember, when we had Sandy on the show, we had Sandy on the show in March. And then Sandy was on the Penn State Sports Network with me in April. And we talked about this, that it's in the last resort category. That hasn't changed. She did say today one of the biggest challenges of a spring season, it's probably the biggest one in her mind, is the proximity to the next season. And this is something we've talked about with all seasons here. And frankly, a second lost spring ball. Overcomable if perhaps we're willing to have a shortened season again in the category of something better than nothing. That may not be a problem at all. Everybody is obviously trying to work and feel their way through this. There's certainly been a rise in coronavirus cases, but not as many hospitalizations. And certainly the death rate has been relatively low. You don't want to see anybody. You'd like to see it be zero, for goodness sakes. I mean, that's what we're all looking for. She did say that there's no doubt there's been a little bit of pessimism the last couple of weeks that we really hadn't had for probably 4 to 6 weeks. I think that's part of the ebb and flow of the virus. Obviously, my hope, Sandy's words here, obviously my hope is that maybe as people start looking at the masking and social distancing again and all the precautions and recommitting to the seriousness of this, we'll see it flatten out. What we're doing is we're planning. Obviously, given the uncertainty, we're having to work on a lot of different plans, a lot of different scenarios. And when the time comes, if it's healthy and safe to do it, we'll obviously do it. We'll have a season. And if it's not, we won't. No student-athlete will lose their scholarship if they're not comfortable returning to their teams during the pandemic, regardless of whether it's during voluntary workouts, when mandatory training for football begins, which will be July 13th, or the start of preseason. That's all about their health and safety and an element of health and safety in their comfort. We have at every turn indicated that if their decision, when the time comes for our teams to be invited back, arrive, the decision is completely theirs, and their scholarship is not in jeopardy at all. Back with more in a moment here on News Radio 1070 WKOK. To have you with us on the show today, brought to you by Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury, Sunbury Motors Key, routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. We will hear from Sandy Barber tomorrow on the show as Penn State continues to push forward, looking at a wide range of scenarios. Look, the last 4 to 6 weeks, things were really looking up. The last week to 10 days, you know, obviously there have been rising cases in several states. Marginal rise in this state, I believe. I know that Center County had gone, for example, I think Center County had a total of 3 cases in the last 5 days. Totally had 4 yesterday. But that's 4. And again, when they tell you, well, how many cases you've had in your county and so forth, they never tell you. Now, Pennsylvania, to its credit, is at least giving an estimate now. They do give an estimate of what 77-78% have now been in the recovered category. They never tell you how many are active. But that's... But let's just see how it plays out. Let's see how the next 3 to 4 weeks play out. The camp part of it gets going here, I think, July 13th, and they really kick it into another gear on the 24th. Then actual training camp goes August 7th. Men's and women's basketball players, men's and women's soccer players, and women's volleyball players are on campus now. Field hockey gets here on Monday. Sandy mentioned today that there have been 102 tests done. I think there are 160 student-athletes on campus now. Well, the first 102 tests they've done, all fortunately, knock on wood, all fortunately were negative. Today's show brought to you by Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury, Sunbury Motors Kia, Routes 11 and 15, and Hummel's Wharf, and online at sunburymotors.com. You heard about the Bobby Bonilla contract. That is not the only ridiculous contract that is out there. We're going to run down some of the craziest contracts and where money is still owed today from names gone by. Amazing.
Hey, heating oil customers. Tired of overpaying on heating oil? Oil prices are low, and it's the perfect time to try Easy Pay by MidPen Energy. Easy Pay gives you year-round price protection on your heating oil price by offering a low capped price and easy monthly payments. There are no fees to join. Sign up by August and never pay more than $1.99 a gallon, guaranteed. Hurry, this limited time offer won't last long. Enroll online today at mid-penenergy.com. Easy Pay by MidPen Energy. Simple, affordable, easy.
Are you a business owner looking for funding? Greenbox Capital is here to help by providing easy working capital loans in as little as 24 hours. Visit gboxcapital.com/apply now to fill out a short form and get started today. With funding from $3,000 to $500,000, Greenbox Capital can help. Visit gboxcapital.com/apply now to receive a special offer of 10% off cost of working capital. gboxcapital.com/apply now and get business funding needed without stress from traditional lenders. gboxcapital.com/apply now. Fast funding for small businesses.
CBS News Update. One by one, governors are reimposing some of their COVID-19 restrictions, including today, Michigan Governor Gretchen Whitmer and California Governor Gavin Newsom.
We anticipate and expect will remain in place for at least 3 weeks.
In New York City, Mayor Bill de Blasio putting a halt to one of part of his city's reopenings.
So I want to make very clear, we cannot go ahead at this point in time with indoor dining in New York City.
Some concerns today that the U.S. is hoarding remdesivir, the one drug approved to treat COVID-19. Mike Ryan is with the World Health Organization.
Obviously, there are many people around the world who are very sick with this disease, and we want to ensure that everybody has access to the necessary life-saving interventions.
U.S. death toll from COVID-19 now more than 127,000. CBS News Update. I'm Steve Futterman.
Hi, this is Scott Paff, CEO of Milton Savings Bank in Milton. While other banks come and go or change their names and lose their community focus, we've remained in Milton serving the needs of our community, as well as Northumberland, Union, and other surrounding counties, all while making decisions right here locally. With 100 years of focusing on residential mortgage lending, we offer purchase money, construction, and home equity loans, as well as personal loans for your other borrowing needs. At Milton Savings Bank, we offer checking, savings, and money market accounts, as well as Christmas and vacation clubs, online and mobile banking, and IRAs. We also offer business checking accounts with no minimum balance and no fees. We're excited to announce our 100th anniversary celebration. Follow us on Facebook for upcoming details. Thank you for supporting Milton's only hometown bank. Not a customer? See what you're missing. Stop in at 80 Broadway, Milton, or call us at 570-742-8541. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
When your comfortable life is good, Comfort Specialist.
At Comfort Specialist, they know when you're comfortable, life is good. Their factory-trained comfort specialists provide you with total heating and cooling comfort. Whether you're looking to eliminate hot or cold spots in your home with a single-zone system designed for one room, or want to take a whole-home approach by replacing your existing heat pump or AC, now is a great time to save with special financing offers. Mitsubishi is offering 0% interest financing for 36 months, and Trane has 0% for 60 months on qualifying heating and cooling systems. Give the experts at Comfort Specialists a call today. They're on call 24 hours a day. 888-524-HVAC. That's 888-524-HVAC. Or find them at yourcomfortspecialist.com.
When your comfortable life is good, Comfort Specialist.
Summer's here, and it's time to enjoy the season. That means it's time to feed your yard with Scotts. It's easy to help your lawn stand up to summer's wear and tear. to keep it lush and green and help prevent those brown spots. It's time to get outside and enjoy every day. And Scotts has got you covered, because even though this summer may feel different, the best things never change. So let's get to it. It's time to enjoy your yard. Scotts, it's good out here.
Asthma symptoms can attack anywhere, like on a city street. Now you can get fast relief anywhere with new improved Primatene Mist, the only FDA-approved asthma inhaler available over-the-counter. So whether you need relief of symptoms at the park or at your kitchen table, Primatene Mist starts working quickly, opening up your airways to restore free breathing. For temporary relief of mild symptoms of intermittent asthma, use Primatene Mist and breathe easy again. Available at CVS, Rite Aid, and Walgreens. Use as directed.
News Radio 1070 WKOK. Local radio here when you need us most.
Every single day, frontline workers put themselves in harm's way for us.
I think colors do make it simple, but sometimes I think green suggests that we're all in the clear.
We had over 3,000 mail-in ballots in Snyder County. That process went very...
Always here to entertain and inform. Local radio serving you 24 hours a day. News Radio 1070 WKOK and WKOK.com. Taking your calls at 800-795-9565. This is the Steve Jones Show on News Radio 1070 WKOK. Now from the Sunbury Motor Studio, here's Steve Jones.
Today's show brought to you by Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, Routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. And online at sunburymotors.com. Ford, Lincoln, Kia, Hyundai. Wow, great product lines. How about pre-owned inventory? Best anywhere. Great sales staff with great deals to tell you about. And also a service department that is fabulous that will take care of the life of your investment. That is Sunbury Motors, 4th Street in Sunbury. Sunbury Motors Kia, Routes 11 and 15 in Hummel's Wharf. All right, let's have a little bit of fun here. Let's have a little bit of fun. And part of having a little bit of fun is this being July 1st. Look, the first half of the year, has been forgettable. So let's have a really great second half of the year. Let's do that. Let's see if that is in our cards. All right. Starting today. As you heard, today is Bobby Bonilla Day. Bobby Bonilla today was given a check for $1.2 million. So Pat McAfee put out his top 16 from the Pat McAfee show of incredible contracts that you don't know about. You know about Bobby Bonilla, most of you do, if you really follow sports. So here are the top 16. And this is where deferred money comes in. It's amazing. Number 16, Ichiro. Ichiro will get $25 million at 5.5% interest over the years after his retirement until at least 2032. Now, I don't think that's $25 million a year. I think it's $25 million total, and then there's 5.5% interest on top of it. Albert Pujols. Number 15. He will get $10 million a year over 10 years when he retires from the Angels. That's not what he gets now. It's what he's going to get when he retires. He's going to get $10 million a year over 10 years when he retires from the Angels. Chris Davis, Orioles first baseman. All right, Dick from Milton, brace yourself. He'll get $3.5 million a year between 2023 and 2032. And then he'll get $1.4 million a year from 2033 to 2037, all from the Orioles. He's going to get $3.5 million a year from 2023 to 2032. And then it falls off to $1.4 million a year from 2033 to 2037. Matt Holliday. For the most part, Matt Holliday made his name with the Colorado Rockies, but he also played well and in the World Series for the St. Louis Cardinals, and at one point he was with the Yankees. Well, his deal with the Cardinals allows him to get $1.4 million a year from the Cardinals from 2020 to 2029. Ryan Zimmerman, who will not be playing this upcoming in this 60-game schedule. He says he wants to be back for 2021. Ryan Zimmerman will get $10 million a year for 5 years after he retires from the Nationals. Again, he'll get $10 million a year for 5 years after he retires from the Nationals. Ryan Braun will get $1.8 million a year from the Brewers between 2022 and 2031. The heroes in this are the agents. This is unbelievable with the deals they got their clients. Max Scherzer will get $15 million per year between 2022 and 2028 from the Washington Nationals. $15 million a year from 2022 to 2028. Brett Saberhagen hasn't thrown a pitch in forever in the major leagues. Yet he is getting $250,000 a year. He started getting that number in 2004. He's getting $250,000 a year over a 24-year span. In fact, it's 25 years total. It runs out in 2028. Daryl Strawberry, starting in 2004 and going until 2033, gets $1.64 million a year from the Mets. That's 30 years. Josh Smith, he was waived by the Detroit Pistons in 2015. But his contract pays him $5.3 million a year and finally runs out this year. It's the last year he'll get the $5.3 million payment. So in other words, he got, what, almost $22 million? Not playing in the last 5 years. Manny Ramirez. The Red Sox are still paying him $2 million a year. This started in 2008. The $2 million a year runs out in 2026. Remember a long time ago, the New York Islanders signed Rick DiPietro, a goaltender, to what, a 15-year contract or something? I remember when it came out, I said, are you kidding me? Really? Rick DiPietro? Well, guess what? That contract is far from done. It has a lot of deferred money in it. DiPietro retired in 2013. He still gets $1.5 million a year until 2029 from the New York Islanders. Darren Williams, in his prime, a good basketball player. Played well at Illinois. He has been making $15,000 a day for the last 5 years. He has made $15,000 a day for the last 5 years. Number three, Kevin Garnett. He retired in 2016. The Boston Celtics still owe him $5 million a year until the end of the 21-22 season. Ken Griffey Jr. is number two. Between 2009 and up until and through 2024 with the Cincinnati Reds, Ken Griffey Jr. gets a check every year for $3.6 million. Started in 2009, doesn't run out until 2024 from the Cincinnati Reds. And, of course, number one, no doubt, greatest contract ever. It started in 2000. It still has 15 years to go. Bobby Bonilla gets $1.2 million every July 1st. It started in 2000. It runs out in 2035. Now, the Mets thought they could do this because of a guy named Bernie Madoff. Yes, Mr. Ponzi scheme. And now the Mets are stuck with this contract. Now, if Jennifer Lopez and A-Rod are part of the group that buy the Mets, they'll be stuck with the contract. To go along with the contract, they're stuck with Brett Saberhagen and Daryl Strawberry. It's amazing. But Bobby Bonilla, every July 1st, gets $1.2 million from the Mets and will continue to do so for the next 15 years. He's already had 20 years. This is the 20th payment he's had? He still has 15 more to go. He's just a little bit more than halfway. Aren't those some of the craziest contracts you've ever heard of? And Pat McAfee from the Pat McAfee Show is the one that put that together. It is absolutely phenomenal. It's phenomenal. Wow. And again, give credit to the agents. They worked out all of that deferred money. That is a lot of deferred money. Who sits there and comes up with that? Is it the agent? But I mean, who in the management side says yes to this? I mean, that's the phenomenal part. Who in the management side says, yeah, that's a good idea? Now, I realize that you're trying to defer money, spread it out. But that's what baffles me. Who says yes to this? I've said this many times when we've seen a commercial on TV, for example, during the Super Bowl, which where you'll see, and I really could care less what the commercials are in the Super Bowl. Some people get really into it. I'm like, okay, just get back to the game. But you'll see one that's an absolute, like, flatliner. And you look around at other people in the room and said, you're telling me that you just paid X amount, which is a gigantic number, to advertise in the Super Bowl. And in a conference room, a group of people said, yes, that's the one. We'll come back with more in a moment. Brought to you by our great friends at Sunbury Motors here on News Radio 1070 WKOK. When it comes to car buying, there's the other guy's way, and then there's the SMC way. The other guys force you into a vehicle you really don't want. The Sunbury Motors way lets you take the time you need to browse, ask questions, and take the test drive and think on it. For over 100 years, the Mertz family and all their employees have made your experience the most pleasant one you'll ever have. The other guys won't offer you the best price for your trade, no matter how much they say they will. The SMC way is their promise to provide you with the most money the market shows your vehicle is worth. The SMC way is to offer you all applicable factory rebates on new vehicles and generous discounts. Looking for a pre-owned vehicle? The SMC way checks each vehicle in a 200-mile radius to determine the lowest price, then beat it. It's the lowest price promise, just part of the SMC way. The choice is up to you. The other guy's way or the SMC way? The SMC way wins every time. Sunbury Motors Company in the North 4th Street Auto Plaza, Sunbury, and at sunburymotors.com. Selling more cars and satisfying more customers for over 100 years. Well, we talked about the testing part, and they've had 102, and so far they've all been negative, which is good. I mean, every couple of weeks, I think they're going to let everybody know. Now, people are wondering, are they going to say names? No, they're not going to say names. And that's why HIPAA was created. I mean, the player's not going to want their name out there. But if there is one, they'll let you know. I mean, at that point, you know, it's, I mean, do you want people to know? Said today, without a season ticket, no matter what our capacity is, you're probably not coming to a Penn State game this year. I appreciate our fans and their fanaticism for Penn State football. We hope to be able to reward them with a safe and healthy opportunity to come and watch this year. She does not believe a full house scenario for Beaver Stadium is in the cards. They have multiple plans in which as many season ticket holders as possible could be accommodated. As possible. Depends on the scenario. There were no confirmation on whether current season ticket holders will be able to resell or transfer their tickets through Ticketmaster and so forth. That was not discussed. But that's, again, something to... You know, these are all items where... These are all difficult decisions. And I can say with complete confidence, well above my pay grade. So there you go. Let's see. I don't quite know what this means. Rachel Levine signed a new order making wearing masks mandatory for anyone who leaves their home. I don't quite know what that means. I mean, does that mean like the second you step out, you have to wear one? Or
I didn't get a chance to read that story. I saw the headline too.
The mask wearing order is essential to stopping the recent increase of COVID-19 cases we've seen in Pennsylvania, Governor Wolf said. Those hot spots can be traced to situations where Pennsylvanians were not wearing masks or practicing social distancing. Two practices must be adhered to. The order outlines the situations when a mask must be worn and includes limited exceptions to the face covering requirement. Okay. I don't really see any detail here. And let's see what the order says. Blah, blah, blah. I'm reading the order here. It's a lot of blah, blah, blah. You know, you get them. Okay. Face covering includes plastic, face shield, whatever. Okay, I'll tell you what it is. Outdoors and unable to consistently maintain a distance of 6 feet from individuals who are not members of their household. So in other words, if you're out there by yourself and you're not around people, you don't have to wear it. If you're around a group of people outdoors, yeah, it sounds like you have to wear it. And indoors, in any indoor location where members of the public are generally permitted. Waiting for, riding on, driving, or operating public transportation. Obtaining any services from the healthcare sector. Engaged in work, whether at the workplace or performing work off-site, when interacting in person with any member of the public. There are exceptions. You may have a medical condition, including those with respiratory issues. Okay.